So now let's talk about how authentication can be implemented. It could be something that the user knows. So this has to be a secret that is shared between the user and the system. And the fact that you're able to produce that secret that's associated with the user, that means you are that person. That is the evidence that you are who you claim to be. A password, for example, is a secret, isn't it? We say, ask people to pick a password that others cannot guess or easily guess. Well, that's your secret. So one way to do authentication is that users have a secret that they can produce to the system, and the system is able to check that the secret really is the one that is associated with that user. The other possibility is something the user has. So think of this as some sort of a token or a smart card or something that you use. And the fact that you have it means you have possession of it. So possession of that token, we have to talk about how this could be used for authentication. The fact that it's with you, smart card or token is with you, a fob, for example, people use that. That's with you. That means it must be the user who you're claiming to be or the user who should be possessing this particular thing. The first thing is something you know. The second is something you have on you or with you. The third thing we can think of is something the user is or something you are. So this could be, for example, your fingerprint. This could be your voice. For example, people talk about voice biometric or their smartphone devices that you can talk to, for example. So this would be some biometric, something that is unique, hopefully, to the user, because we don't want somebody else to become you. So this biometric has to be something that's specific to you. And if you're able to produce that, if the system, you're able to give that to the system and the system is able to check that actually it is your fingerprint, then the authentication is based on something the user is. Something you know, something you have, or something you are. These are sort of the three basic methods that are used in almost all the authentication techniques that we use in computer systems. So we're going to, again, look a little bit more deeply into how authentication is implemented using one of these methods that we talked about, a secret you share with the system or something you have or something you are. So the basic sort of sequence of steps that we're going to have is that the user is actually going to come to the system and is going to request access to it. And we know that is going to start with request for authentication. You first have to authenticate yourself. The system, the operating system here, is going to take whatever claim about identity you make. So for example, you may be saying, this is my login name. So it's going to read those keystrokes, and that's who you are. And if you're providing, for example, a password, then the operating system at this point is going to run this login program. And the login program is going to check that the information that you provide, for example, the password you provide, is really your password. Is the password we have associated with this user. If there's a match with what the system knows and what you provide, that is a true positive. Okay? If it's the right user, then that's a true positive. The outcome is positive here. So the user is authenticated. And when the user is authenticated, a user shell, this is how you can now initiate, you know, any further actions that you want to perform. So this is sort of the case where the right user provides the right kind of evidence, the login program is able to check and successfully log in the user. Well, the check could fail. And if it fails, then the system believes that the user has not provided the correct information. And if the user has not provided the correct information, it's probably not the user who is being claimed. Okay? The identity that is being claimed probably doesn't belong to the user who's asking for authentication. So this could be impersonation, for example. So in this case, the system doesn't have the right evidence, doesn't have this match, so it's not going to authenticate the user. So in this case, authentication fails. Maybe you retype your password. If you're not the right user, then that's a good thing. So then that, if you are not the right user, you're trying to log in as Alice and the system says no, that's good. That is a true negative, actually. Okay, the outcome is negative and it's the right thing. Okay, so Eve tries to log in as Alice, and we end up here. That's a true negative. When Alice tries to log in as Alice, we come here. That is a true positive. So this is how the authentication process is implemented. A couple of things to know here is that we have to read the evidence or capture the evidence. We have to compare it and then decide whether there's a match or not, and go either this path or the other path.